is Philip. Today he would define the American dream as to work hard, play hard, and get ahead. Born in 1949 in Brooklyn, New York, Philip did everything right as a baby boomer and got a scholarship to play baseball at St. John's University. It was the 60s, lots of parties, so it kind of got him into a little trouble, and when the draft hit in 1969, Uncle Sam came knocking. Too good to join the Army, he enlisted himself as a Marine and would serve two tours as a sergeant recon in the Vietnam War. Surviving that was probably his American dream. Across the country was a girl named Ninfa, born in 1956 in a border town of Texas. While the baby boomers were twisting and shouting, she was following the crop, picking cotton and grapes with her migrant working family, immigrant parents, and family of 10. Her American dream was to get an education, to get out of the following crops, and to be a working middle class citizen. She graduated from high school, and she took temp writing classes, and she would soon become a bilingualist for a small company called AT&T, which she would work her way up, and eventually that Philip guy would become her boss's boss. So a Vietnam Marine and a migrant worker during the Cesar Chavez time, they built the America that we're in today. They gave us the capability to have an American dream. They were just simple people who did what their country needed from them at the time, and they built the America that we live in. So why are these people important to my story? They're my mom and dad. A Brooklyn boy, Marine, veteran meets a Mexican migrant worker, pretty rare. But what they did throughout their life was how I was raised. And no matter what their differences were, working hard was a must. And being reminded that I would be the first to graduate from college was the American dream for their daughter. And anything less would have been a disappointment considering how hard they worked to get to where they were and the world that they brought me into. So essentially my American dream was to fulfill theirs. Go to college, be successful, to make my parents proud. But that all changed when I was 12 years old, my mom was diagnosed with triple negative breast cancer. Normal teen might think about sports, grades, what time I should go be at the mall, but when cancer came, that all changed. I worried about what medications my mom was taking, when her chemo radiations were, when she had surgery, when it was time for me to take her to the hospital, what the difference between an emergency or her rashes or when to bandage her up. It was constant and it was exhausting. I didn't look sick, but I had to grow up really fast and be her caregiver. At 13, the bills started piling up and she couldn't afford my dance or anything extra, so I got my first job at a local pool so that I could pay for it all. Oh, she's so beautiful, isn't she? Even though she smiled through it all and tried to make everyone think that she was okay, it wasn't at home. And I fell into a deep depression. My grades started going down, my social life as well, and I started self-inflicting harm to move the pain from the inside to the out because it was too unbearable for me. Just seeing her so sick, it was really hard, and seeing her deteriorate in front of my eyes and eventually passing away, it wasn't easy. And eventually I did receive the help that I needed, but not everyone does. And 5 million children have similar stories like mine, but it's hard going through things throughout your life that can impact your life. And the things that happened in my life, they changed the trajectory of where my American dream would go. But in the end, I just wanted to be happy again. I wanted to go to college, and not just for my parents, but for me. And to be able to say that I am more than my mom's cancer, and I am a fighter, and I'm gonna graduate and be a college graduate, hopefully. And the American dream is making your parents proud. But in our world today, with the increase in poverty, illnesses, mental health, it can easily be hindered by unimaginable obstacles. So in the end, the American dream is to be successful and to make your parents proud. But